Johnson goes into training for his first title defense. Johnson loves to perform. Give him an audience and he's at his best.
I love controversy. Black versus white, heavyweight versus middleweight. Two champions fighting for the pot of gold. I'll be laughing while Stanley's bleeding.
A lady watches.
They say I'm supposed to carry Ketchel. They always talk about me. Let them. I'll give them my answer in the ring.
The lady waits for Johnson to finish. The lady is back in Como, California, October 16th, 1909. Rumor has it that Johnson will carry Ketchel to make it look good for the cameras. The first suspicion of a fix in Jack Johnson's career, but not the last. When Ketchel appears in the ring, minus shoulder pads and cowboy boots, the physical differences are startling.
Be careful. This man's a champion, and champions know what it's all about. Better behave now, Stanley.
A combination of blows, and Ketchel goes down. By round nine, Ketchel is exhausted. Courage, raw courage, keeps him on his feet.
Don't go down yet, Stanley. We got a little way to go.
Ketchel's face begins to show blood. Johnson stands off and flicks stinging left jabs. Ketchel looks for that one punch. Johnson steps back from a wild left and then ties up the challenger.
Easy, Stanley. Hold it, Stanley.
The pace has been blistering. Ketchel is still putting up a fight as they wait for round 12. Ketchel throws an overhand right, and Johnson goes down. Ketchel has done it. Johnson rolls over and rises. In slow motion, all of Ketchel's weight is behind one looping right. Slowly, Johnson begins to gather himself. He seems dazed. Ketchel's confidence soars. A perfectly timed straight right to the jaw smashes Ketchel to the canvas. Johnson's momentum sends him hurtling over the fallen Ketchel. Johnson wipes two of Ketchel's teeth from his glove. with shocking suddenness. Jack Johnson knocks out Stanley Ketchel and successfully defends his heavyweight crown.